silent standing tonight. My question is, in the future, if ever you get to have a son, what would you teach him about women?
If in the future, if I would have a son, what I would tell him about women is he should respect them like he respects his mother, because every woman can be a mother, and if you show that respect to every woman, then you know how to respect yourself as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Janet, number 15, Pamela Bianca Manalo. And that, ladies and gentlemen, concludes our question and answer portion with our 10 finalists. Judges, I have no idea how you're going to decide on this. All 10 of them had interesting and fantastic answers. So good luck to all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, a lot more surprises in store. You're watching the Filipinas 2009. Stay right with us. Good job, girls.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the traditional serenade of our semi-finalists, please welcome the cadet choir from the Philippine Military Academy with actor, model, and director, and one of the world's sexiest, Mr. Ding Dong Dantes.
handang mag-alay sa iyo.
A special tribute to Binibining Pilipinas International Crown Holders follows next on Binibining Pilipinas 2009.
Before anything else, we would like to thank the wonderful benefactor of Binibining Pilipinas charities after all these years, Mr. George Araneta. It is now the 45th year of Binibining Pilipinas, our country's most prestigious beauty contest, discovering the most beautiful, the most worthy representative of the Philippines in the international arena of beauty. Join us now in remembering the most outstanding international Binibining Pilipinas beauty queens.
Binibining Pilipinas, a hallmark for the best and the beautiful. Gloria Maria Aspillera Diaz was only 18 when she flew to Florida to join the highly popular Miss Universe beauty pageant, only one among the many. Tiny compared to her colleagues from all over the world, Gloria won the judges with her wide, toothy smile. Gloria Diaz came home to Manila bringing with her the distinguished title of Miss Universe, the first Filipina to do so. Another Filipina would duplicate Gloria's breakthrough triumph in 1973. She was Maria Margarita Rojas Moran. The granddaughter of a former Philippine president, the 19-year-old student was egged on by friends to join a beauty contest, describing her beauty as classy and elegant. By coincidence, the Miss Universe pageant that year was held in Athens.
If I had a million bucks, I'll buy a house and land and be by myself.
And there, in the mythical splendor of Greece, Margie stood out like a true goddess of beauty. Aurora McKenny P. Juan was an outstanding candidate during the Binibining Pilipinas beauty pageant in 1970. A tall and sprightly lass from Bacolod, Aurora was a sure winner from day one of the Miss International competition in Osaka, Japan. Her victory made the country leap with joy, duplicating an earlier feat of another Filipina, Gemma Teresa Guerrero Cruz. As Miss International in 1970, Aurora P. Juan added a milestone to Philippine history as the first country to win the crown twice.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a fitting end to that tribute, let's give a resounding applause to the presence here tonight of distinguished film and television actress, the 1969 Miss Universe, Miss Gloria Diaz. Successful entrepreneur, jewel of the Pearl Farm in Samal Island, Davao, Miss Universe 1973, Margie Moran Florendo. Distinguished civic leader and member of the cause-oriented Gawad Kalinga, Miss International 1970, Miss Aurora P. Juan. And to present awards of recognition to our international beauty queens, our Binibining Pilipinas 2008 reigning queens, Patricia, Jennifer, and Danielle. Thank you very much. You made our country proud. The reign of our Binibining Pilipinas 2008 beauty queens has come to an end. The year has been truly blessed with their contribution to the promotion of Binibining Pilipinas beauty pageant. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here to bid us all goodbye for a successful reign as Binibining Pilipinas, last year's winners in their traditional farewell walk.
Representing the Philippines and making it as a finalist in Miss International was a glorious experience for me. This is where it all began. So let me thank those who have helped me take a magic carpet ride this year. Thank you to Madam Stella Marquez Araneta and Binibining Pilipinas Charities, my co-winners, Jenny and Danny, and Nadia Alicia and Shami for your professional support. To all the sponsors of Binibining Pilipinas 2008 who helped to improve my looks, my personality, and my outlook in life so I can become the best Filipina I can be, I hope I did not disappoint you. To my family, Lolo and Lola, Mama, Papa, Kuya, Katie, Aya, and Jeffy, and to everyone who has been part of my home, you know who you are. I love you all. And to my aunts, Chuchit, Rosan, Carlene, Cecil, and Girly, I am forever grateful. To the one who will wear my crown, may you be worthy of the prestige, honor, and fame associated with Binibining Pilipinas. Lastly, I would like to whisper a prayer to St. Jude and St. Therese for their miraculous intercessions that have made things come true for me, from our God Almighty.
Farewell, Binibining Pilipinas Universe 2008, Jennifer Barrientos.
I remember the night I won my title. I was excited and happy, not for myself, but for the people who sacrificed a lot for me to achieve my goal. My papa, mama, and my sister, my greatest gifts from God. I cannot thank you enough, my dearest family. My journey to the Miss Universe contest wouldn't have been easy without BPCI, and my second mom, Stella, who treated me like a queen for that rare privilege to represent our country in an international beauty pageant. The experience has made me and my co-winners, Daniel, Patricia, Nina, and Elizabeth, true comrades in beauty and spirit. The friendships we've made will never be broken. God has been so good for making this possible, seeing me through the end of my journey, only to start another, a new life away from the spotlight, but near the hearts of the people I love and wish to serve. To my successor, cherish every moment and never forget what brought us all together here, the unifying experience that makes us all proud to be one nation of beautiful people. To you, my countrymen, who followed me in the news, on internet, on TV, and my wistful thoughts, you are the jewels of the crown on my head, for you certainly made me feel like a winner. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. At mabuhay ang Pilipinas.
Farewell, Binibining Pilipinas World 2008, Daniel Castaño.
Representing our country at the Miss World 2008 beauty pageant in South Africa was an extraordinary experience. I met people from various cultures, and it made me realize that beauty unifies diversity, especially beauty that comes from a person's heart. I want to thank my parents, who never wanted me to become a beauty queen, but supported me all the way just to fulfill my dream. Thank you for your love and deep understanding. To Madame Stella Araneta of BPCI, thank you for trusting me. To your staff, who took good care of me, I shall never forget. To all the sponsors who believed in me, I hope I did not let you down. And to all my friends, thank you for staying up with me during those sleepless nights when I was preparing for the competition and sharing the excitement and disappointment with me. You were inspiring. God, all these things would not have happened without your blessings. To my successor, being a beauty queen is not just glitz and glamour. It is a responsibility. As I pass this crown to you, I also pass you the magic that comes with it. The magic of knowing the real beauty never fades. Good luck and make our country proud.
Thank you to our lovely queens. And when we come back, it's the moment of truth for the 10 finalists vying for Binibining Pilipinas 2009. So stay with us for these glorious moments.
One.
Welcome back, you're watching Binibining Pilipinas 2009, and Isa, this is it.
Yep, right now, Again on stage are our 10 finalists for Binibining Pilipinas 2009. Please, let's give them all another warm round of applause for their wonderful participation tonight. Thank you so much, ladies.
And at this point, Lisa, I'd like to call up Mr. Lito Montez from SGV. He has with him the results. Let's start out with the runners-up.
Here are the runners-up for Binibining Pilipinas 2009. Now, these ladies have important roles to play throughout the reign of Binibining Pilipinas. They are winners themselves. And in any eventuality, they must be ready to take the place of any one of our title holders in case she is not able to discharge her duty as Binibining Pilipinas. That said, here is our second runner-up. She is candidate number 11, Regina Han.
Presenting the award to the second runner-up winner is Binibining Pilipinas Universe 2005, Giona Cabrera.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. And here is our first runner-up. Let me call in candidate number 3, Richelle Angalot.
Congratulations, Richelle.
Presenting the award to the first runner-up winner is Binibining Pilipinas World 2005, Carlene Aguilar.
And now, folks, it's about time that we announce our title holders. The ladies will be going home with a crown, starting out with Binibining Pilipinas International. Who's it gonna be? The winner of Binibining Pilipinas International will be representing the Philippines at the Miss International Beauty Pageant in Macau, People's Republic of China, and in Tokyo, Japan as well. Here we go. Congratulations, candidate number 20, Melody Gersbach.
Presenting the award to Binibining Pilipinas is Binibining Pilipinas International, Patricia Fernandez.
Congratulations, Melody. The first crown belongs to you. And now, it's about to announce our Binibining Pilipinas Universe. Binibining Pilipinas Universe will represent the country at the Fantasy Island in the Bahamas. Wow. Binibining Pilipinas Universe is candidate number
15, Pamela Bianca Manalo.
Presenting the award to Binibining Pilipinas Universe is last year's winner for 2008, Jennifer Barrientos.
Congratulations. We have one more crown for tonight, and this is Binibining Pilipinas World, and she'll be representing the country at the Miss World pageant, which will be held in South Africa. Here we go. Who's it gonna be? Bini Bini Filipinas World for 2009 is candidate number 17, Marianne Umali.
Presenting the award to Bini Bini Filipinas World is last year's winner for 2008, Danielle Castaño.
And second, runners-up, congratulations to all of you ladies. Isa, it was a pleasure working with you.
Thank you, Paolo. And thank you to everyone who is here tonight. And thank you to our audiences. And of course, to our judges. Maraming, maraming salamat po.
That's right. And next year, of course, you can expect a bigger, a brighter Pilipinas Filipinas 2010. God bless everyone. Take care.
Put your hands up, baby. 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 Oh, 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 oh,
Binibining Pilipinas 2009 was presented to you by GMA and Binibining Pilipinas Charities in cooperation with Natasha. Also brought to you by Sunsilk Smooth and Manageable, 4G Antioxidant, Adaneta Center, and Philippine Airlines.
Sina first runner-up Richelle Angalot, Binibining Pilipinas International Melody Gersbach, Binibining Pilipinas Universe, Pamela Bianca Manalo, Binibining Pilipinas World, Marianne Umali, at second runner-up, Regina Han. Congratulations sa inyo. This is for Melody, Pamela, and Marianne. Do you have plans of joining showbiz?
For me, as of the moment, I haven't thought of it. I'm concentrating myself on the international pageant. So basically, my mind is set on the trainings, whether it is walking and public speaking and other kind of trainings.
For me, I'm not closing any doors. If I can contribute to the movie industry, then why not?
And Marianne?
Yes, I am not closing my doors for anything, but now I'm still focusing on being Binibining Pilipinas World.
For Rich naman. Rich, anong feeling mo ngayon?
Well, I'm still happy that I landed in the top five in Binibining Pilipinas 2009, and I know that I've done a pretty good job in the pageant, so I'm satisfied and I'm content.
And for Regina, ikaw naman, anong immediate plans mo?
Well, for now, I'll just dedicate my time to Binibining. Maraming mga trainings in store for us, training sa speaking, sa walking. Maraming din kaming mga guesting. So I plan to dedicate my time to fulfilling my duties as a second runner-up.
Thank you very much, ladies, and good luck to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Reunion concert ni Eraserheads, nagsilbi rin tribute kay